and certainly I'm not certainly absolving myself of any responsibility on the player personnel, and this isn't just an indictment of Todd, like, or the players. I mean, this is a collective thing, and it's our job to get to the playoffs, and we owe it to our fans, and I felt this was the right move for it.
Ken Hitchcock, why Ken?
I had the experience of working with Ken and Sochi. I got to know him fairly well in that short period of time. Obviously, his track record is impeccable. He's a very good tactician. What I saw was a real high level of input in a short period of time. You can extrapolate that a little bit here. Like, we're 2 months in, and we don't have a full season left. So he knows how to inject system structure, execution in a short period of time. So, and well respected and a taskmaster, and he's got a lot to his portfolio, and I felt it was the right person for the job.
With Todd, was it more strategic or just the players weren't kind of responding the way you'd hoped?
Well, I saw some things that were resurfacing, and again, not an indictment on Todd. He's a good man, and he's a very good coach. Yeah, he's going to be a very good coach in the league again. I just saw some things that we had a good start. We had a weak start, but we had a real good stretch, and I don't think we overachieved. And then I just saw some reversion back. So I can't tell you. This isn't scientific. When there's a sense and a feel, and you talk to people, and I saw levels of flatness, levels of non-response. And when that happens, the radar goes up, and so we decided to act.
Hitch can be like a glass of cold water, to his credit. I mean, he gets teams to kind of change the way they approach the game. Is that what you're looking for here?
Yeah, my other answer, I think, you know, you can put it different ways. Glass of cold water, he can instill something in short order and execute and direct it. He's going to be here for the year, and then we'll evaluate at the end of the year. But had some good discussions with him latter part of yesterday, and he's very excited. You'll talk to him later, but he's very excited and motivated, and had our team down as far as player to player and systems and whatnot.
No changes, obviously, to this point with the assistants.
The assistants will be here. Yep, they'll remain.
Will this change the way the Oilers play a little bit? He has kind of a reputation for being a shut it down defensive coach.
Yeah, I think you're going to see more of that structure. But we talked about the forecheck being aggressive, and if you can recall when we were playing, well, it was aggressive. The second man was pretty proactive, and even the third man was shading towards the puck. So we want to get back to that. He does have, like, elements of his game are defensive, and he talks about from the dots to the boards, the play and the dots to the boards, and that's important. That's wall play. That's where a lot of the game is, so you'll see more of that.
He integrated some younger players, even in Dallas in last year. Could you potentially, I mean, I know you've got Puljujärvi and Yamamoto down right now for a little, you know, confidence building session. Was that ever a discussion with Ken about the possible deployment of a couple of your younger guys and getting them involved and seeing if we can get going with those guys?
Yeah, it was. It was certainly that we talked about a number of things, including integrating some youth, those players specifically. They've got a good stretch of games this week. I'll be at two of them. Keith will be at three of them, Keith Gretzky, and so we'll see how those guys are doing. But yes, that was a point of discussion.
Todd, I guess, when did you tell him, and what was his sort of response to the news?
I told him early this morning, and he was obviously disappointed. As I said, he's a good man, and we talked about a number of things that will remain private, but we've all been fired before. It's not a good situation. So, but he's a good man, and I'm sure I'll have another discussion with him at some point. And as I said, he'll be in the league in short order, back in the league.
People thought that he might get this trip to kind of salvage it or save it. What was the tipping point? Like, when did you decide, okay, we have to make this change?
It really came up after the Sunday game, and slept on or barely slept on it, and then started thinking about it in the morning. And you know, we travel. Unfortunately, Todd had to come with us, which was unfortunate, but certainly not planned. It would have been nice for me to make that decision earlier, but you know what? It's maybe it was the Thanksgiving, American Thanksgiving juncture point. Maybe it was just, you know, 6 out of 7. I felt like it was time.
With the roster, will that change? Like, is this team good enough no matter who coaches it, or do you want to make some moves?
Well, we might look at some moves. I think it is good enough. Mm-hmm. I think players, again, we none of us can absolve ourselves in this situation, including the players, so I think they can be better.
You have a number one goaltender who's really struggling right now. Was there some discussion points with Ken as to try to how to get Cam Talbot recalibrated? His last 5 starts, he's got a, like, he's been sub 904 of those 5 starts.
Yeah, that was, again, we touched on a lot of points, and obviously goaltending is very important, and we talked about that, and we talked about Koskinen also.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.